So we'll get a screwdriver. And a good evening to you.
What are we doing, John?
We cooked substrate for a long time. I turned it off at like 8 o'clock last night, and then I had to work today, so it's been since 8 o'clock last night. And we're at like 6 o'clock. So it's 6 o'clock, you know, time. Got the lid unhooked here, pop it open. Just wanted to show you temperatures. I want to kind of see for myself. So these top bags are around 72 degrees. Barrel's about 70 degrees. So it's a little chilly down here. Don't feel like no 70 degrees, but all right. So I got to move the blocks back into the room. And I got my fan going. Micro-filtered air in here. Keep it nice and sterile. Before I do that, better plug it. It's called an impulse sealer. Plug it in. Plug it in. Turn this light on. Pretty loud fan. Sets you down. Like they kind of back seal all that heat. That's a nice block of sawdust and soy pellets. Now let's check. Got down in here a little bit. Let's say in 100 degrees. Woo! Still kind of warm. That's more like it, probably 80, 90 degrees. So yeah, metal layer is still nice and toasty. Keep going here.
Whatever, bro. Alright. I'm ready then.
Yep. Looking at about 100 degrees, that bottom layer. That'll cool off pretty quick though. And the 90. 70. So, there we go. Now, the grind spawn is the part that we got to do now. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Man, you guys want to check it out? See what's going on, do you? Let's see what happens. Should have mixed that up before I cut that off, but that stuff didn't look real nice, so I didn't want to mix it up with that stuff. So Dad's gonna have to conjure away here to get this mixed up. 6 pounds grain spawn. Gonna dump it into 12 bags. So about a half a pound a bag. Let's see if I can do that.
Bam. Now, here's the impulse seal time, baby. I'm gonna get you up close to the fan so you're not gonna be able to hear anything. It's not like I'm talking about anything important anyway. Watch it seal up. I do my corner first because my sealer's not big enough for the bags to fit in by themselves. fresh air in there. Some of that sterile air, man. Missed it. Let's show you one of them. Now that you get it sealed, in there, you mix it up. And there you have it. Inoculated. Lion's mane on the way. It's gonna be awesome. Inoculation. My bags. What's up with my bags? Yo, turn the fan off finally. Got them all sealed up. A lot of these are already shaking. Got some more to shake. I like to be spaced apart a little bit. Just still a little in action. Yeah, boy. Yeah, let's mix one up again so you guys can see. Dang. David. You guys might be able to see nothing. There's a little bit of air in there. I probably could have put a little bit more air in there, make it a little easier. So the block of substrate is kind of stuck together, so you kind of just bust it apart. You want the grains to go all the way around. The whole idea. Bust it all the way apart. Shake it all the way upside down. Oh, that's why I turned it back on. I don't remember.
This is a great exercise for putting your love into it. And while you're shaking it up,
it's one of the things I do, just like saying I love you when I start the process of putting the pellets in the mix tub to mix it up the substrate, and just continue doing that through each process. And that way you are vibrating that love. Wow. Uh-oh. It must be like time. Dang, it's probably 7 o'clock or something. I don't know, I've been down here. So, where was I? That totally lost me. Oh yeah, so putting your love into each step of the process, verbally speak it out loud, as well as think it and feel it. And I'm already excited because lion's mane is one of my favorite mushrooms to eat, even better than the old elusive morel mushroom. Believe it tops it by a lot. And yeah, so they get the good feeling. The good feeling energy transfers into the bag while you're shaking it. It transfers into the bag while you're filling it and mixing it. And then I'll keep you posted. We'll see how it goes, and we'll see what kind of fruits come out of the bags. I've even thought about writing on the bag specifically to see, just as, you know, that's what you do with hobbies. You can experiment and have fun with this stuff. Like, that's what it's all about. Enjoying the experience. Enjoying life. Love you.